In a different town literally every single day, you name it. I just want to say, first of all, thank you to all my previous subscribers and all my subscribers. It's been amazing. The channel has been growing. Thank you so much for catching all the shots. Thank you so much for also watching the previous videos. If you have not watched, you can go right through and watch all the other videos. So yeah, I just want to say thank you to everybody for just the support, the engagement. It's really been awesome. Thank you so much. And thank you to also my new subscribers. If you don't know me, please do watch the Get to Know Me vlog, which is right below, and you'll get to know me just a little bit, and also by watching all my other vlogs. So currently I am home and in the Eastern Cape in South Africa, and I've been here for like 2-3 days, but I've been home for like 2 weeks already. I stayed in Joburg for a couple of days, then after being in Joburg for a couple of days, then I went to East London. East London is East London in the Eastern Cape. That's where I grew up, that's where I did high school, primary, you name it. South Africa is normally not this hot, but wow, it's really, 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 really hot. Yeah, so you're gonna see like parts of me just showing you around and the preparations, but I'm not gonna like go through the whole thing on how to do it, like from first day to second day and third day, like how I did the last time. So the very detailed video or vlog is right on the description, or I've linked it on my description box, so you can have a look at how to make Umkomboti in South Africa. Umkomboti is African beer. If you haven't tried it, you have to come to South Africa and give it a try. Yeah, so I'm gonna show you. So this vlog is basically me also in preparations of going on holiday, because I am going on holiday. I will do a whole vlog on the holiday series, because I'm very excited for that holiday. It's a whole thing. I'm kind of on holiday now because I'm away from work and I'm on holiday, but I'm also doing a whole holiday, because I have this thing, but you're not really on holiday if you take time off and go home, because home there's a lot of things that you have to do and it's not really holiday. So I'm doing like an official holiday, me and the word official. Yes, I'm always saying welcome you to South Africa. Ekaya is Lalini, in the village, in Ngcobo, countryside, whatever you want to call it. But I just want to welcome you home, as I'm home for a couple of days, and from there doing the preparations for the holiday that's coming up. So let's do a whole couple of days at home vlog. I don't even know what to title the vlog. And yes, since I want my and doing the vlog, but if you don't know me, to my vlog, I want to welcome you all to this new vlog. It's fun here, it's nice. Yeah, so guys, also please just like the video. Like, it helps if you do. Just click the like button. Don't forget to also subscribe. Let's talk, let's have a conversation. I love it when people engage with the content. Shots have been doing very well. I've been very happy with my shots. Long videos are still a little bit of a struggle because we are trying. But yeah, it's a whole thing. What I also didn't tell you guys is that I actually am part of the YouTube Made For You. I applied for the program, and basically the program has really been a lot of insightful lessons that I've gotten from them. It's been very, very educational. I've learned a lot of things from the guys in terms of them telling like them sharing some important tips on how to be successful on YouTube. There's a lot of things that I was really missing out on, and I've learned quite a few things, but the thing is that I've learned quite a lot of things. The program though does just focus on just shots. So that's why I've been posting a lot of shots. But in me posting a lot of shots, I've also met a lot of my new subscribers, which are now watching. Welcome again to the new subscribers. Thank you very much. I hope you love it here. I hope you enjoy. Actually, you will enjoy it. Kumnandi apha. This channel is all about travel. This channel is all about discovering a different world. I know that sometimes with the life that I live, it's a little bit hard to relate because I'm like never settled. I'm never in one place. Like even when I was looking through my demographics, it was so tricky because I saw a whole lot of countries that I was like, okay, India, Philippines, Ethiopia, US. And I was like, yo, I don't know who I'm talking to. Kanene, I really don't. I saw South Africa. Like, yo, it's a whole lot. But the YouTube Made For You program has really helped me so much to grow and to organically just grow the channel and to also learn so many things about YouTube in terms of engagement, in terms of making informative videos and being able to just be consistent, because the consistency is something that I was lacking on. But being part of the program made me to also be consistent, because you have to post at least once a week, and that's what I've been doing. But I've been doing a lot of short form videos. This is why you haven't seen a lot of the long form videos. And also I'm learning a lot of things in terms of giving out different content, because some of my travel videos are also very much like not me talking a lot. Some of them are me talking a lot, some of them are not me talking a lot. Like now in some of them I'm just like literally showing you around. But yeah, this vlog or this platform for me, or this channel, is basically about lifestyle. This channel is basically about travel. This is a channel is structured in such a way, right, in such a similar way on how my life is. It's not like my a whole summary, it's not a summary of my life, but it's structured in a way that I kind of live, because I'm always in different places, different countries, different cities, different villages. This is what I'm saying. But yes, it is a travel. This is a channel that I'm just discovering a lot of things. I'm so grateful for all the lessons I've learned in the previous year, also with the program, YouTube Made For You program. It's honestly been so educational. It's honestly been so informative. And it also makes you feel like you're part of a community, because being part of YouTube, I think recently, also for small channels, it's quite a challenge, because there's so many of us getting into the platform right now. And it can also be overwhelming with people that are already successful and that have been doing it for some time. Because you're trying to find, when you look at it from the outside, it's like, oh, it's so simple. But it's actually not. It's a lot of work. It is honestly a lot of work. Big up to people that are actually successful on the channel and continue to push themselves and that do it for a full time, for a living. Because it's honestly not, it's not easy. Like putting yourself out there and putting your life out there and trying to grow at the same time. The numbers, oh my God, the numbers. It's like you're posting, and then five people or three people. But I've learned to also be grateful for the two people, for the three people, for the five people, for the 10 people, for the 100 people that are watching. Because sometimes with social media, we get so overwhelmed with into yoba, oh, it's only 100 people watching. But imagine those 100 people if they were there and you could actually see them. 100 people is a lot of people. So I've learned to be very much appreciative in terms of the people that do watch, even if it's one person, even if it's three people, because it takes me back to the core of why I'm actually doing the channel. Because this channel for me is basically to inspire the next person to say, you can also do it. You just have to put yourself out there. And also journaling life and seeing that as Ndoni, life is so interesting, and being able to educate in however way that I can educate or show you a different side of the world however way I can, you know. So it's basically me just putting out and journaling. It's a digital journal for me. So I going back to that core and understanding what the goal is really has kind of refocused me and made me more consistent as well in doing it. But again, like, yeah, I want to say to all the small channels or other people that are watching, like, being consistent is great, but the numbers I know can be very discouraging. But at the same time, you have to just remember why you're doing it, what is the goal, you know, and appreciate the people that are there and are consistent in watching your content. Appreciate the five people or the three people or the two people, because I always say, if imagine if you had like thousands and thousands of people, but you don't impact anybody anybody from the thousands, or you're not able to reach out or to send the message that you want to send. So rather have the 3, rather have the 4, rather have the 10, rather have the 100 that are consistent. And I'm happy to say that I'm starting to see that consistency in terms of the people that are coming back. And I hope that I get to inspire you in some way, and I hope that you get to relate in some way, and you can share your own story in terms of how life has been. Life is amazing, life is beautiful, and that's what I'm sharing here. A beautiful life and a beautiful side. It's not an overall summary of saying this is my life, but it's just basically from time to time coming in and checking in and saying, you know what? So right now I'm gonna leave, as I just came to just do a quick intro, and I'm gonna wash the pots and ndizohlamba imbiza ezinyama because besipheka izidudu. So now I'm gonna prepare to wash the pots, and then also prepare to wash the pots, prepare uhlamba imbiza. And then Lindwena I met Funendi Vasile, because I met Bindi Kupi from the day Benfica, because I was like, I'm so Ivasa, and it's still waiting for me. It's a lot because Gushushu is so hot. It's so hot, and this hat is just giving right now. But yeah, I'll catch you guys as in Bizen. So from the time that I did my intro till now, this is the only time that I'm actually getting to do the pots. I'm finally about to wash the pots, because I've literally been delaying the whole day. I'm about to also catch the sunset. Oh my god, guys, the sunset. Look at that. Oh, the views. Oh guys,
Bilali.
Yeah. Oh, how beautiful. Yeah, Bilali. How beautiful. How stunning. One of the most fortunate and one of the most privileges is to just watch the sunset. I love sunsets. I will catch sunset anytime, any day. Call me up. I am there for it. Yo, I live for sunsets. I will go for it. How pretty. How beautiful. This view is giving life. This view is giving. It's just giving. It's just giving. Stop watching these parts, because I can literally do this the whole Friday, the whole evening, the whole afternoon. This would be me watching sunsets the whole afternoon. I want to try and shoot a rail or a shot as well. Let's wash the pots. It was a lot. So today is day two, and it's a little bit cold. Look at this one. So today is the day before Umqombothi. The day before the big day Umqombothi. So it's the evening, it's a little bit chilly. It's actually, it's cold actually. See, this is why you get flu, because one day it's cold, then it's hot. But yeah.
I'm a gwinya. This is a fave, guys. This is a fave. Oh, we're gonna have one. Tataba wins the amagwinya. I'm a gwinya. If you don't know this, again, come to South Africa and you will love this. This is a must. She is making. Yo, yes, switch amagwinya. And you put polony inside. Aye, you finished the job. Especially when it's hot. And you sometimes fake in it means. Yo. Amatumbo. Ugaleleke. Ugalele. I think so. Khotseka. Hey guys, I just want to welcome you back on the actual day, which is today is Umqombothi.
Okay.
So I just wanted to welcome you guys back to this vlog. Today is the actual day. This is the reason I'm whispering is because you can't hear me because everybody's in the kitchen. So yeah. So this dirk is a dirk that, this is not actually the dirk, this is my mom's kind of small blanket that she puts over her shoulders, but I decided to make a whole wrap around it. My aunt helped me to wrap it around because I know how to wrap it, but not that well. I think she's good. Like, somebody probably has to help you wrap it around. Unless you're really good at these things, then yeah, you'll be able to wrap it. But yeah, she did like a whole wrap for me. So yeah, I love it. It's giving, I'm a little bit oily because I've been running up and down, but basically this is the whole fit. It's very, very, very hot as well. So yeah. It's probably like 32 or 30 degrees, but this is the whole fit. It's giving bright vibes. So this we call umbato. What I'm currently wearing right now is called umbato, traditional wear for amaXhosa, kwaXhosa, and I'm wearing a different color. So sometimes you also see people wearing the white and black one. I have the white and black one. I will put the picture right there so you can see it. This one is a different color. I just like the brightness of this whole fit. I love the different colors as well. I think it just works with the yellow and the white and the beads on the side. I decided not to wear beads because it's so hot and beads can also be a little bit much, but I think also they would have been just too much because I was working, going up and down, doing dishes, cooking and all those kind of things. So I was like, beads are not gonna be it. But pretty much this is the whole fit. This is the whole fit. I love it. This is the whole fit with the different colors. It's very chilled vibes. And I decided to do like little edits because it was very big on the waist, because I have a very small waist, so it was big. So I added this on top, but you don't necessarily have to add it, but I added this on top because I didn't. This is actually the duke for this whole vibe. Okay, so I just added the whole thing, but the detail, the attention to detail. I don't like how this flaps over, but this sits like way down. And yeah, look at that whole detail. Very hot. Yeah. I guess this is gonna be it. I don't know if I'll take you around most of the things. But we almost finished now. Everybody's drinking, it's just vibes. People are chilling, socializing. But honestly, this is such a beautiful, beautiful special occasion. It's such a beautiful special occasion for me every time I do it, because it's just a way of giving thanks and being grateful for the progress that I have, the amazing things that have just happened in my life. And I'm just grateful for so many things. I always get very much like overwhelmed on the specific day with this special occasion. I call this a special occasion. I never know where to start or what to say because there's just so much to share. I get overwhelmed. I become a little bit speechless. As well. I never know what to say because it is one of those events that really do touch my heart in so many ways. And every time I do it, it's just... Inhliziyo yami iba mhlophe to express myself in Xhosa. Inhliziyo yami iba mhlophe. Abantu abadala bethetha bekunika the blessings. It is so beautiful. Iba yintle man la nto bayenzayo. Like umamela abantu abadala bebulela bethetha. It really warms my heart. It really does. I'm really, really so grateful for the family that I have, for just being in this place. I'm honestly very, very grateful for this moment. I'm grateful for everything. I'm grateful for the people that are part of my life and part of this journey that I'm currently in. There's a lot of noise happening because there's people there talking and everything, but I just want to come here and just say also to all my subscribers, thank you so much for being part of this journey. Thank you for everything, for liking, for subscribing. Don't forget to subscribe. If you've also done something like this, let me know. If you have something, an occasion like this in your culture, let me know. What is it? What do you call it? KwaXhosa, we call it different things. For me and my family, we call it umhlinzeko, umqombothi. And yeah, it's been a whole thing. I decided to come up here and just say, yeah, it's a vloggy. I had to cut my nails because when I was doing the whole thing, it was not vibing. It's hot. I need to brush it. Just checking in on a different day. Today is Saturday the 10th. Yesterday was my birthday, so I took some time off. And it actually has been years since I have spent my birthday at home. I think the last time I spent my birthday at home was probably 3 or 4 years back. So it's been a time. I didn't do much because we did umqombothi most the other day, right? So umqombothi it's like a day, the actual event, but it still lasts a couple of days after as well because there's still leftover of umqombothi. Wow, English is a lot. So yeah, so basically people were coming back yesterday to drink whatever was left over. So yesterday I was assisting people as they were coming back to drink that. And it's a lot of work. You're by a 7 sababantu because basically bayabuya and they just like, oh, ngicela usela, ngifuna usela lento, ngifuna ukuthi. It's a lot of admin. So basically I was with a lot of people yesterday. There was a lot of in and out that was happening because people were coming back to drink whatever was left over from the previous day. So yes, and then later on my dad bought me cake, so that was great. So it was me, my brother, my mom, my dad, and we just had a nice dinner. I made dinner for us, a very simple dinner, umngqusho with chicken stew, and then after that we had the cake. We had cake. So after that we had cake. So it was really like chilled vibes. Being a kondo ngaga we too. It was just a nice day, enjoying. Yeah, so it was just fun, just spending the day with parents and being home. I love being home. Like I just love being home. But at the same time, home can be a lot. It can be a lot, a lot, a lot. So yeah, so today is the 10th. So again, today people are still celebrating my birthday again. So all the socials are celebrating my birthday. I would probably go through the story. It's a little bit windy. Yeah, so yeah, that was the day for my birthday. But yeah, so I'm about to clean. Yesterday I decided not to be in the scenes and just catch up with myself as it was my birthday today. So I just decided so today what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be even like what am I saying? Like, I'm saying so many things. It's so funny. I'm saying so many things. But yes, my parents went to a funeral and they have expectations that when they come back, dinner or lunch should be ready. So what I'm going to do now is clean the house. And then by the time they come back from the funeral, food is ready. I don't get it. Why do people go to funerals and come back hungry? But yeah, anyhow, another thing, I have to pack. I have to pack for my vacation because today is Saturday and then tomorrow we go back to East London. And then on Monday, I am testing for my driver's license. Guys, wish me luck. Yo, it's a lot. Into your tester for a driver's license in South Africa. It is a lot. It's a lot. It's a lot. So I'm testing for it on Monday. And then on Tuesday, I'm leaving to go to Johannesburg. And then on Wednesday is the big day that we jet off and we are leaving for vacation. I don't know why I'm saying we are leaving for vacation. Let me say actually we, because I'm taking you guys along to the vacation with me. So yes, it's the time that I'm going for my true vacation on Wednesday. So I'm gonna do my hair. I'm gonna do like a sew in. My cousin is gonna be doing the sew in. I hope it comes out right because I have like an idea of what I want. I don't even know if I should like dye the hair or something. Maybe I will probably dye the hair. I haven't decided what I really want to do, but I know like the style that I'm going for, but I haven't really decided on the color. But yeah, tomorrow I'm doing my hair. Tomorrow we're driving back to East London, and then I'm doing my hair, and then probably do my nails. I'm not really that person who always does the nails, Kasana. I'm not that girl for nails. I'm really not. My nails though do grow very quickly. And I have pretty decent nails, but see me grow them. Such a mission. I'll probably just paint them. That's what I'm thinking of doing. Just paint them. And then yeah, so namhlanje, the big thing is for me to pack. Packing frustrates me. Like, it frustrates me. It's a lot because I'm already a suitcase girl. So I never know what to take. It's like, I know I'm not going for a long time, right? Because I'm going for a bit and then I'm coming back. So I'm going to go for 2 weeks and then I'm going to come back home. And then I'm going to be going then back to work after the 2 weeks. So I haven't really decided
on what to take with me. I mean, so yeah, in the comments, guess where I'm going. Guess, give me your guesses. Where do you think I am going for you for this whole holiday? I mean, yes, let me know in the comments what you think. Where do you think I'm going? I'll give you guys a hint. Like, where I'm going is very hot, so I have to pack basically jeans, shorts, dresses, nothing warm, but there's a lot of stops because it's quite a long flight. But it has a lot of stops. This was actually one of the things that when I was booking this flight was really, really stressing me out, because it was regarding like visas and transit visas and all these things. Yes, booking your own flights is a lot of admin. And on top of that, like, it's just a lot. And I'm that kind of person who's always, like, I did this holiday like 3-4 months ago. I started researching it then, but I wasn't really decided where exactly I was going. So it's only like a month ago that I really made my mind and said, okay, this is where I'm going. So it was quite a mission to book everything out. But like I said, I will do a separate vlog when I'm at the holiday, when I'm at the spot. When I'm at that country that I'm going to, then I will let you know all the details on how it's like basically to book your own flights, to book your own holiday, your own vacation, what it comes with, the planning, the preparations, the cost and everything. So I'll try and do a whole different vlog when I get there, and I'll welcome you guys officially when I get there and tell you where I am when I get there, because it's a whole holiday. Yeah, it's a whole holiday. Yes, I'm so excited. Anyway, let me start cleaning because I'm gonna go on and on and on and on, and I need to pack while I cook. So I'm gonna multitask, and I'm planning cook and pack for my vacation. I'm such a vacation babe. I am such a vacation babe. It's not even funny, because I'm just that guy. I'm just that girl who's like, I am going to sign up, guys. I cannot. Like, I go, I come back, I'm just like, you know. Anyway, see you guys later. Let me get into this. See you guys then. So this is the current situation. My plan is to start off, I'm unpacking some of my things from those two cases and this carry-on. I'm unpacking it into my wardrobe and also packing some stuff as well to take with me. To take with me on holiday. So one of the items is gonna be, I haven't actually worn this dress as yet. I got it in Aruba. There was a big sale in Aruba, so I will be wearing it on vacation. It's like one of those hot dresses. Like, it's one of those hot red, I don't know, it's one of those dresses that you wear out when you're going like for a dinner date, like, yeah, when you don't know what to wear and you want to look cute. So yeah, it has like an open area. You probably don't see what I'm doing here, but it has like an open area or something. And then, so one of the dresses I'm carrying, I have 5 swimsuits that I'm taking with me. I think that should be good enough. Let's see. I have this green lime color, and I have this purple one, and then I haven't worn this one as yet. Also got it in Aruba. It was on sale for $20. Then I'm taking my pink number, love it. Then I'm taking this green one as well. This one I got, where did I get this one in? I can't remember, but that's why I wore in Curacao. So I'm taking 5. I'm tempted to take another one because I'm going to be spending a lot of time at the beach. Then I'm going to take one of my bucket hats. Croatia vibes. I don't even know why I got a whole weed, Croatia, a whole weed. How do I not take this on vacation? Like, it's giving beach vibes. Wait, I don't think you can see what I'm doing here. Okay, now you can see me. I feel like it is giving. I don't know how many dresses I've taken now. So this is one of the dresses.
This is my capri dress. My capri dress. I love this dress. And of course, I'm going to have the big hair, like a whole lot of hair, and it's going to be popping. So this I'm taking for sure, we're taking this one. And this one. Okay. So this is tricky. I love how the whole thing with the fringe at the bottom, but I feel like I don't have the height for this dress. But again, when I have the right hair and everything, it comes alive. So I'm gonna be taking this one as well. I love this dress. It's a pretty dress as well. I was actually wanting a two-piece when I bought this dress. That's what I had in mind. I don't know if you know those pants that are knitted kind of the way like this, basically. I wanted a two-piece where I could get like the pants and the top. And the top would be like a high-waist pants and a crop top kind of vibe. So yep, this dress is going. So sit. This is the other dress. This is one dress. The good thing is that when I'm going to the beach, I can wear this. I can get away with wearing this because it's not as see-through. It's actually not see-through as well. It's actually not see-through at all. It really isn't. It's very neat. It's knitted very well. It's not see-through at all. So I can wear my bikini underneath and I can be a girl at the beach. But if I decide like I want to go out, let's say just chill somewhere and not go to the beach, I can still wear it out and not feel like it's a lot. And then I'm gonna take this one. I haven't worn this as well. The other dress I have, this is like a cover-up. Let's see. Look at the tags, because this girl hasn't worn most of her stuff. Okay. Look at this. So this one is a whole cover-up. I'm taking this as well. Because we're gonna be going to the beach, of course. I feel like it's gonna be so cool as a whole cover up. Okay. Haven't worn that. Oh my word. Okay. Let's get back to this. This suit, this case is done. I'm just gonna try and move some stuff down there and put some of the stuff. But most of the stuff that were in this case and the carry-on did fit. These earrings. I bought these earrings. And I haven't worn them. I had a whole vision when I had them. I thought like I would wear like, I don't know. I got them at Zara. I got these earrings at Zara. I was gonna initially wear them at a dinner date kind of vibe. But maybe I should take them. You know, maybe there's gonna be one night that I'm gonna dress up and be all at a vibe and have these nice earrings that I'm wearing. Never know. Let me take them with. They don't weigh that much anyway. Okay. Here's another dress. I keep on buying these things and I never wear them. I got this dress as well at Zara. Another Zara item. I haven't worn it. We were gonna have dinner at work and I thought I was gonna wear this dress and it never happened that I wore the dress. That's actually why I bought the earrings, because I wanted to wear the earrings together with the dress. Why am I not taking this dress with me? I mean, I don't know where I will wear it, but I don't know, like I might just go for a nice dinner. Actually, one of these days when I'm on vacation, I am gonna wear a nice dress and I'm gonna go have dinner somewhere. Or I'm actually gonna wear it when I am in Joburg or something, because we still have the YouTube made for you thing. So I don't know when the graduation is. Maybe it's when I come back. If it happens when I come back, that's also the plan that I had. I thought I would wear this dress. If I do wear this dress, in the background, I'm also watching one of the vlogs I was doing in Italy, Cinque Terre. So yeah, I'm gonna take it in hopes that I'm gonna wear it. One of the items that also hasn't been worn. Wow, this girl. So I'm on my second case now. I don't think I'm keeping track of what I'm doing now. I'm just like literally throwing. I'm also gonna take these tights, because I haven't worn them actually. They're very nice tights. I might use them to go hiking. So now so far I put out three tights. I have this one, the blue one. I haven't worn the blue one. And this green one. I love how this one just holds everything together. And I have a black one as well. And then I have the shorts. So I think that's it with gym items. Because I always bring a lot of gym items and I never wear them. What else is here?
One of the suits. I'm not gonna take any suits. I bought these because I wanted to put them in between my clothes, but as I pack. But I think I'm actually gonna put them in my wardrobe as I pack. It's just, this is like a softener that just makes your clothes. You can. It's a softener actually. But I've seen people that actually just put them in the wardrobe so that the clothes, even when they're in the wardrobe, can smell fresh. Because I'm never home, so when I come back, it's nice to have clothes that smell fresh. I'm not taking this one. No, tights again. Short tights. Short tights. Maybe when I'm just chilling in the house, I could wear these. If I will be chilling. Oh, my fave. Of course we take this one with. I've had this. Let me tell you a story. I've had this for close to 6 years now. I bought it in Bahamas. And I've absolutely enjoyed this top. I've enjoyed it because I wear it everywhere, every time. And I'm taking it with because I am going to wear it. Especially when I go to the beach. And I'm going to take this one shirt. Not that I'm gonna wear it, but I might wear it. I'm thinking what outfit would go with this shirt with the stuff that I did take with me. My jeans. Okay. Jeans and a white shirt. This I don't think this I love this under this bra vibe thing. Cause it kinda holds it together. if I don't wanna wear a bra, it kinda works. Tops. One more top. My money. Should I take one more top to take with me? One more top to take with me. I love like a plain t-shirt. It's so me, but I cannot take so many plain t-shirts. Either I take this one or I take the lazy poet out. It's kind of the same thing. The only difference is that the one with the lazy poet, it's not really white, it's kind of like beige-ish. So maybe I could take this one and that one. I'm also going to take a scarf with me because I'm going to be passing via a very cold country. So when I'm at the airport, it's really going to help me out versus me having a jacket. Leather jackets, I'm not going to take any because I just feel like it might be much. Yeah, I've got this white one that I'm tempted to take, but at the same time, I'm like, I don't know. Okay, let me get back to this. What is the best way to store a leather jacket? I'm so hurt because I love this jacket. And now look at the back. It's absolutely damaged. I haven't worn this in like a year. And I've had it here in the case. And now it's damaged. How is the best way to keep this? I don't know whether it's the dry air or what, but it's just not working. Now I'm scared to put these ones in because this might happen. I need to do some research on how to actually store this stuff. It's absolutely damaged. I cannot wear it. And my other black one, the same thing happened because I put it inside and I don't wear it. So I don't know if I should keep my other ones in here as well. I've kept it here the whole time.
Oh, you're too good.